Good afternoon, folks. This is Marius from MariusLandon.com and from the Twitter handle LandM_Marius. This is the only authentic Twitter handle account in the world, LandM_Marius. Please follow us there. And the purpose of this video is quickly to show you why we believe that the low for Bitcoin, which we called on the 29th of March 2018, is indeed the low, and that we do not believe that Bitcoin will go lower than that. Okay, as you can see here on this graph that we've got, or this chart, is that Bitcoin has been following a downtrend into a kind of like a wedge pattern. And now I quickly want to show you what we see, and hopefully you'll understand where we are coming from. If you look at this little fractal here, and we've actually put the wedges in already there, so I'll just draw that again for you so you can see that's a wedge, there's another wedge, there's another wedge, and there's another wedge. And what has happened with this is that Bitcoin would go sideways and drop, and then go up and then drop again, like this big drop there, and go sideways again, drop, and then it would just go and follow that exact same pattern. Now we call the low for Bitcoin at 6550, and you can see at this time it bounced 1, 2, 3, it will probably go 4 and 5, maybe another one, just try and pierce through that bottom. But that bottom has really become like a solid support now, and we are really happy to see that over the last six days. Now over the next 7 days, what I want you to think about is something really remarkable that we believe will happen over the next few days. As you can see here, is that Bitcoin traded sideways, it dropped, and then it shot up, and then we got the drop. Now what's it's going to do is exactly the same pattern. It's going to go like that and potentially going to drop there again, and then go sideways up again till it reaches that level there, have another drop, and come here 15, 16, 17, this weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, it's going to go like this, very erratic, and then suddenly just push out and go to all new highs. And potentially what we're looking at is that it could break then the 8,000, 9,000, 10,000, 11,000 and beyond. Now there's a lot of talk on the internet, and we posted some of this out again, that China is investing in Bitcoin. They put 1.6 billion aside. If they normally say 1.6, you can times that by 20. We also got the George Soros, the Rockefellers. The Rockefellers are actually one of our clients, not the Rockefellers themselves, but some of their companies, and we do business with them by providing information to those companies as well. But go through our feed and you'll see there's a lot of data here, especially this guy from Japan. These guys are starting to invest billions of dollars into cryptos and cryptocurrencies, so there's a lot of confidence that we get why this will actually break out and move up. Now 90%, 99% actually of TAs actually say that the market is going to come down here and then potentially just go like this and then just break down here. We say that is not going to happen. You know, we believe that this is the case, that we're going to break upwards. And the reason for that is, like I stated, you know, that we get all these billionaires that are now starting to invest into these companies. Now, when do these billionaires start to invest? Not now. These guys, they will wait till we break these levels, until we break potentially that level, and then they'll start investing there. And as we head up here and we start breaking these levels here, they start investing more and more. And at these levels, that's actually where I will also start investing a lot more of my money, more the real money, the large sums of money, because you want to make sure that you do have that breakout and the market has turned around. So yeah, we're not saying that it is not going to happen, but we don't see it in our data, folks. We don't see it in our behavioral assessments. That actually shows positive. We see the sentiment has changed very positive for Bitcoin. The money is lying in exchanges. There's Australian financial institutions that have got 1.7 billion that they just put on exchanges now, ready to buy. And as I say, these guys are going to start buying when the market turns around here. But you can definitely see that this has come down. It's created a cushion, like a little bit of a foot. And it's going to turn around and then either go up extremely high because of the pressure, or we can just see a gradual breakout. But whichever way you look at it, folks, we believe that the bottom is in, and the bottom is 6550. We wish you the best, and have a blessed day. Thank you.